My name is Brad Albin. I play upright bass with the Time Jumpers. I've been with the Time Jumpers for about 3.5 years as an actual member. What is my most memorable experience in the music industry? I have a couple. One was getting to see Roy Husky Jr. play. He was my hero, one of my heroes, bass heroes. He was an upright bass player that passed away in 1998. And when I moved to town in 96, the first time I got to see him play live is one of my most memorable memories. And the other one would be the first time I got to go in the recording studio with members of the old A-Team from the 1950s and 60s, Harold Bradley, Lloyd Green, Big Robbins. My heroes, the guys that cut all the stuff that I love to listen to, and I got to be there and play upright bass with them for my first time. Those would be my two biggest memories of the music industry. Where do I get my style inspiration from? For about the past 4-5 years, the only music I've been listening to is old pop and jazz from the 20s and 30s. And I just kind of started getting into that whole vibe and looking at some of the men's fashion, the classic fashion of that era. And I just decided there's not a lot of people that wear that well anymore. So I've started trying to move in that direction of wearing a little older, more old-timey menswear. Sweet Rowena was really, really fun when we recorded it in the studio. We just finished another track, I don't know what it was, but Vince started playing this really greasy, bluesy groove. And we had no idea, he just started playing it and the rhythm section joined in. We started all playing together and he started singing it. And it just morphed into this really, as the parts got worked out and other members of the band started working on things. And the neat thing about Rowena was when we finally hit the button and started recording it, we recorded the whole song, but as we were getting to the end, it took on a whole different vibe. The feel, the groove just really got good. And so we just kept going and started the song over without even stopping it and just kept going. So it was just one big long 10-minute track, and I think what they used was the second half of that, because we never really got the worst this band is ever gonna sound is really good. But something happened on the outro of the first take that when we hit that spot, it was like, that's where we need to be. Now let's just keep going and do it again with that vibe. So I think that's how Rowena kinda happened. And it's still, when I hear it, it's like, yes, that's good.